Hey there, people! Shifter 100 today, welcome to more Enchanted and the School Wizardry! Last time! We helped a yeti discover flowers, I guess. Or learn to make flowers. Because that's a thing in this game. This time we're going to... It's another another mystery, and this one, quite frankly, you don't even need my help on, to be honest, on this one, but I'm going to do it anyway for the sake of consistency, I guess. This one has a particular story to go with it, which I think I remember. I might be wrong about the story, to be honest, but it's the one I remember. But first of all, I have to try and find her, which is probably going to take the longest part. Oh, no. She's right here on the bridge. Yes, let's buy a match. And I just gotta do that every day. Now, I haven't played today, so I'm going to quickly do my stuff. And whilst I do, I'm going to tell a little story about the matchstick girl. Because I'm just going to cut to me buying her matchstick skin. She needs to do that for 3 days. And basically, I think it was Christmas Eve. And there was a... This was back in the day where there was horse-drawn carriages and such. And there was a girl selling matchsticks. Corner. It was late in the evening, and she hadn't sold a single matchstick, and she was afraid to go home to her father because she hadn't sold one. So she just stayed out just a little bit longer to try and sell at least one match, with no avail. So I can't remember why at this point she decides to run off somewhere. And she runs into an alley, still too afraid to go home. And decides that, and because she starts to feel get really cold, and so she decides that just lighting one match cannot hurt. So she strikes a match against the wall, and suddenly gets overwhelmed by the smell of turkey, Christmas turkey, and all the other and lots of other festive smells. And she's so much in shock that she doesn't notice the match burning out until it almost hits her fingers. And then it drops, and when it goes out, the smell disappears. So curious, she strikes another match, you get the same smell, and the smell of maybe a Christmas tree? I am slightly making this up, to be honest. It has been a long time since I read that story. And once again, she is so in awe by this, she didn't notice the match burning out until it hit her fingers, and then she dropped the match and the smell disappeared. Not really caring anymore, she strikes the whole lot, and that's a lot of frickin' matches. She strikes all of the matches against the wall, and sees this scene, this amazing Christmas scene, with like an open fire, and a massive Christmas tree, and a huge Christmas dinner, just all for her. And then the matches burn out, and then the sight is gone. And she has no more matches to keep herself warm. So she sits there freezing to death. She looks up in the sky and sees a shooting star, and remembers something her grandmother said to her. If you see a shooting star, then smile at it, because a shooting star is a soul on its way to heaven. The next morning, a passerby saw a small girl who had frozen to death in an alleyway. The most curious thing was that there was matches scattered around her, burnt matches, and she had a smile on her face. That is one of the grimmest stories I've ever heard. I'm not gonna lie. And there's a chance I've remembered that incorrectly. I'm gonna be honest with you. There's a chance I remembered that incorrectly. But that's pretty much the gist of the story. That's what the matches look like, by the way. And you want to keep hold of at least one of these for the sake of because of the next mystery, because you're gonna need them. So I shall cut to buying a few more matches from her. See ya in just a moment. Ah, but Oh god. My foot's asleep! My entire lower leg is asleep! Ah! She's by the... She's over here this time. Okay. First of all, before I talk to her again, I want to say something. The guide I use doesn't really say what the special characters say. So, I think the story I told might have given a bit of a clue to what happens to this girl. Thank you. Oh, I must sell more. I have 3 fucking matches. How many more do you want me? Do I have to buy matches from her until she vanishes? Okay. Yeah, I think I did kind of spoil what happens here. Thank you for buying so many matches. I'm going to see my grandmother soon. But I still have a lot of matches to sell before I can go. Well, see you later. Okay, it seems I have cocked up this mystery slightly. You have to buy matches until she vanishes. Not one per day like I initially thought. Okay. Well then. I was like, I'm going to be playing for a while once I do the chores for every single day. Oh boy. Meanwhile, my leg is falling asleep! Actually, before I disappear for this day, I want to quickly have a look at the bulletin board to see what the notice says about her. Because I have not been showing those, because there's usually a notice on the notice board saying something about the mystery. It's usually quite funny. So what do they say about the match girl? Nothing. What nothing? If you get that reference, I will love you. Okay, is she over here again? No, she must be on the bridge. No? Okay then. Where is she this time? I haven't fucked up the mystery, have I? She can't be gone. Have I completely fucked this up? No, I don't. I really don't. Where's she gone? Where has she gone? I should probably guess, it's a mystery I haven't done before. So I don't know where she is. Oh, for God's sake. Well, on the plus side, it is Sunday. I think I can show off Captain Dot by the time I'm done here. Oh god. I don't know. I don't know where she is. Nigel, tell me, please. Come on. Yes. Shopping Avenue, okay. I will buy all the matches. I think I'm starting to run out of inventory space. Little girl, so you don't have to die tonight. I will give you all- I will buy all of your matches. As much as your hallucinations of Christmas scenes must be quite appealing, I guess. Don't do it! Don't go into the light! Shopping Avenue, where along Shopping Avenue? There we go. Yep, she's certainly looking a little better. This episode's running on longer than I thought it would. Thank you, you've made my day. How am I even going to make use of these matches? What am I supposed to do with these matches other than the next mystery? And for that, how many matches do you even need? I will keep buying your matches. I think I've sold enough now to go see my grandmother. I have to thank you for all the matches you bought. Thank you. Thank you so very much. I'm going to hurry over to my grandmother's now. Goodbye. And then she died. How did I tell you the story? Her grandmother was dead. On to Captain Dot! What, you think I'm joking? Ah. So I'm not recording in my usual place because I'm at home and the washing machine's on. I can't record like that. So I'm in my living room, on the floor, cross-legged. And that does a killer on my blood supply. Oh god. My right leg's dead. I can't feel a fucking thing. Okay, enough of my dead leg. So I've been looking forward to showing off Captain Dot properly for some time. Because I didn't do his music justice, to be honest. He is the best music. He is the best theme. For this game, anyway. Because I will admit, I think the only music that I like in this game is the winter music. And Captain Dot's battle theme, and the title theme. To be honest, it's 365 days of Haunted Cats and Magic, which I liked it. I have it on my MP3 actually. Nobody knows where he's up to. It's always there right through the fog. It's before. Like, I'll go much higher than that, and from there, it seems to be gibberish. You can't tell what she's singing. Then it goes, that everyone has a song in their heart. Oh, fuck. I don't know. Captain Dot. Fight me, sir! I've noticed there's no actual skull on his hat. He has crossbones, but not a skull. Like, this is something I've noticed. Recently he started giving me pirate furniture, which is pretty damn cool. I'm pretty sure this is a rare furniture set. I don't know if I could say I've beaten him 20 times. I feel like I have, but the game doesn't seem to think so. Oh, okay. I missed! Of course! Let's play Curse! I should be very good at these fights by now, but so even I'm not immune to missing occasionally. Oh, for God's sake! You have to wait for him to strike, otherwise he'll just block it. And plus, he's standing nice and still for you, so you might as well. I'm gonna be quite nice and actually listen to the music properly. Gah, I can't believe I lost the likes of you. Guys, your dirty treasure mag table like just like I promised. Next time you wish you were walking the plank instead. I should not try and do pirate voices. I think we can all agree. Don't try voice acting. I don't have any room because all the damn matches. The matches. I have flowers I can plant. Pretty flowers. Pretty flowers. What am I going to do with all those matches? What am I going to do with all those matches? Holy cow. Because that's a lot of matches. Anyways, I think I can live without showing you Catsif again this episode, because this is, I have time traveled over the course of about 3 days to do this.
3 or 4 days? 3 or 4 days.
Sorry. So, I think I can live without showing you Catsif again today in this episode, so next time on Enchanted back in the School of Wizardry, as we endlessly fly across the ocean. Sorry, we should be doing the next mystery, which might take a while actually, because it's forced mystery time. So, and forced mystery time won't happen till the 22nd, and I can't do a mystery between then, so it might take, probably won't be next week, but it'll be the week after, when I can finally do the mystery again. Which sucks, but that's kind of how it is. That's just how this game works. So, this has been the Stepfather 100. I shall see you guys in 2 weeks' time. Goodbye.